Hello everyone, this is Tanuja Gupta and today my topic is prokaryotic cell part 2. And this is the structure of a prokaryotic cell and these are the points which I am going to discuss: cell envelope, lysosome and chromatophore, flagella, nucleoid, pili and fimbriae, ribosome and inclusion bodies. But this point I have already discussed in my part 1. For reference, you can watch that video and I will share the link in my description box. So let's start with the next topic, next point, that is mesosomes and chromatophore. Okay, so mesosomes are basically, they are membrane extension, you can say. It's a membrane extension, or you can say it is a membrane enfolding. Or there's one more thing which is called invagination. Right? So basically it is what? That plasma membrane, it gets enfolded inside the cytoplasm, which is called the mesosomes. Here I mentioned mesosome. Right? So you can say it is made from the plasma membrane. Now, what is the role of this mesosomes? So let's have a look of the functions of mesosomes. So main important function, or it acts like as a mitochondria. Mitochondria, because it has various oxidative enzymes which play role in various functions. So on the basis of the position, they are of two types. I am talking about mesosomes. It is of two type. One is peripheral and another one is, right? So peripheral means what? Those mesosomes which are present nearby the plasma membrane, and the central which are present nearby the nucleus or deep into the cytoplasm. Okay, so peripheral mesosomes, they play role like, it play role in cell respiration. It also help in cell secretion, right? And central mesosomes, they play role in DNA replication. And one more is cell division, right? So if anybody asks what is the role of mesosomes, you can talk about these all role. These all are the functions of mesosomes. Besides of it, one more thing what it do, it extend or it enlarge the surface area. It enlarge the surface area. As you can see, if I will stretch it out, so it will increase the surface area of the plasma membrane. Right? Now, what is chromatophore? It is also same, the membrane enfolding. But the difference in between these two, mesosomes contain the oxidative enzyme, whereas chromatophore, they contain the photosynthetic enzyme, or you can say photosynthetic pigment. Right? You can write this one, photosynthetic pigment. So obviously if it is having photosynthetic pigment, then it will play a role in photosynthesis. So in which bacteria they will be present? They are present in the photosynthetic bacteria, or you can say they are present in cyanobacteria. Okay, so I hope this point is clear to you. Now let's have a look of the next point, that is flagella. The structure of flagella, it is basically an extension from the cell wall. Extension of the cell wall. Mesosome was the extension of the cell membrane, but it is the extension of the cell wall. Its main role in motility, right? If we'll go for its structure, they are consist of three parts. One is basal body. Second, hook. And the third one is filament. Okay, the basal body is this one. Fine. So as you can see, this is the cell wall and this is the cell membrane. Right? This is hook and filament. So basal body is basically embedded into the cell wall and cell membrane. Okay, both. Fine. It ring. It has two pairs of rings, which is divided into two, outer and inner. Right? The outer ring, this is the outer one ring. Can you see this red one structure? Here this ring is called L ring and this one called the P ring. And this is the inner one ring, which is called S ring and M ring. So outer ring consists of L and P ring and the inner ring consists of L, S and M ring, right? The hook, the main role of hook is what? To connect the basal body with the filament, right? And the filament, it consists of a protein called flagellin. This is the protein, okay? Just remember it. And the role of flagellin protein is what? It is a type of contractile protein. Okay, I'm repeating again. It is a type of contractile protein. So basically, it helps in motility. Right? So this is all about the flagella. Let's have a look of next one, which is what? Nucleoid. Okay? As I've already told you that in prokaryotic, there is no cell membrane bound organelle. All are without cell membrane. So, nucleus also doesn't have the nuclear membrane, right? Doesn't have the nuclear membrane as well as the nucleolus. It is a central solid part of nucleolus. So, it doesn't have the nuclear membrane and nucleus. Then what? We will say is not nucleus, it is called nucleoid. Right? So, well, basically where it is present, this is the structure of a bacterial cell and without the nuclear membrane, it just contains part in the cytoplasm present like this. Okay? So, this is the nucleus. Now, besides of it, there is one more structure which is the extra chromosomal circular structure. What? It is a circular DNA which is called plasmid. Right? So, you may be asked that what is the role of plasmid? Fine. So, plasmid is basically responsible for providing the resistance against the antibiotics. For example, ampicillin, tetracycline. So, these are the antibiotics which against which the plasmid provide the resistance. Okay, so this is all about the nucleoid. It is pili and fimbriae. As you have noticed that this is the structure of a bacterial cell and from here a small thread like structure arise. They are large in number as compared to the flagella. Fine. So what is this? Basically mean for attachment. Okay, fine. It is made up of a protein called pilin. Okay, now based on the structure, they are of two types, longer and shorter. Okay, the longer pili and shorter pili. The longer pili is called the F pili, or we also called it as a fixed pili. Okay, based on the presence of this F pili and absence, they are of two type, F plus, F minus. If it is present, F plus, absent, F minus. They are responsible for conjugation, right? They help in reproduction. How? This is the bacterial cell, okay? And suppose this is the F plus and this is another bacterial cell which is F minus. So, it doesn't have this one. So, they make a sex pili and through this the chromosomal material, it pass on into the next bacterial cell. This is how the conjugation, this process is called conjugation. This is how the reproduction takes place, right? Whereas the shorter pili is called the infective pili. It is called the infective pili, right? It is made for the attachment. Okay, and basically where it is found in the pathogenic bacteria because it is responsible for the infection. That is why it is present in the pathogenic bacteria, and they are also called as infective pili. Okay, I hope it is clear to both of you, all of you, sorry, this longer and shorter pili. Okay, and yes, one more thing, this infective pili, this shorter one is called the fimbriae. So I hope it is clear what is the difference between pili and fimbria. The longer one is called pili and the shorter one is called fimbria. Clear? Okay. Now the next is ribosome. As ribosomes, it is present in the cytoplasm. Okay. And it is the without membrane structure. It is without membrane. Okay. There is no membrane present in the outside the ribosome, as this is the structure of a bacterial cell and they are present like this, okay, in the cytoplasm. Now the next is, what is the role of ribosome? It is the site of the protein synthesis. Here the protein synthesis takes place. Fine. There is one more type of ribosomes are present, which are called polyribosome or polysomes. Okay, what is it? It is like, there is on mRNA so many ribosomes are attached. This is the mRNA and a large number of ribosomes are attached on it. This structure is called polysomes. See, this question has come in NEET exam, so you have to focus on each and every word. Any word can come in your exam, so you should be very alert about it. And without membrane, protein synthesis, and they are called polysomes. So this is all about the ribosomes. Okay. Now the next and last point is inclusion bodies. Inclusion bodies are what? They are mainly responsible for the storage of some material. On the basis of it, there are various type like phosphate granules. Granules. Yes, one more thing. They are also without the membrane. There is no membrane bound. Phosphate granule. Second is cyanophysian granule. Third one is glycogen granule. So what does they store? They store phosphate granules, they store the phosphate. Cyanophysian, it is stored the starch. And glycogen, it is stored the carbohydrate. Besides of it, there's one more, is gas vacuoles. They are also comes in category of inclusion body. Mainly they are present in the photosynthetic bacteria. Photosynthetic bacteria. They are also present in green purple bacteria. Okay, so in all these are present, so they also comes in inclusion body. So I hope this topic is clear to all of you. If you have any doubt, please ask in the comment box. I will try my best to solve it.